Thank you for giving up a little bit of your recess. I won't hold you long.
It's fine. I didn't bring my dogs outside because I'm kind of still a little sick. But I'm not contagious anymore. So that's good.
Did you miss any days?
Birthday.
You were sick.
I was gonna miss Thursday, but I didn't want to because I didn't want to be that far behind. I was like, well, honestly, Chelsea, it's not really your choice. I was like, skimming all the medicine you have, just bring my temperature.
Anything
out
to make me feel better.
Yeah, that's what I always tell her. And she's like, Chelsea, medicine's not always going to work for your temperature. And I'm like, just give me something.
Yeah. And anything.
Like, I think until she was like 99, 97, like getting up there.
Yeah.
And like when I first started getting sick and stuff like that, like before I threw up and all that. And then I woke up on Wednesday and I had a temperature of 103.
Wow. I was like, you got sick. Oh, you got there fast.
Yeah. I feel like because I was really cold when I started getting sick, I get really cold. And I just like covered myself with like a bunch of blankets.
Oh, okay. Well, the weather did not help at all with the way it changed.
They have seasonal allergies.
Well, I just wanted to bring you down, just a reminder, you know, what you stand here stays in here, which is another reason I asked Mrs. Majesty to, you know, not be in when we're talking, just because, you know, it's just us. I wanted to piggyback on our conversation last time when we talked about journaling and everything like that to kind of help process your emotions. How's that going?
So good. I feel like drawing is one that I do more though.
Oh, you draw more?
Yeah.
You didn't tell me that part. You said that you like to write, sometimes sing. I didn't know you like to draw too.
Yeah.
So how has drawing helped more than writing?
I feel like because I can go through detail, you know, like or stuff like that. Like you can do it with writing and stuff, but I feel like drawing expresses more. It's like a different emotion.
So how's that going for you? Like how's that working with your processing your emotions?
Okay, but I feel like one thing that really works for me is saying how I feel through a song, because I really like writing music and playing the piano. But I can just, you know, there's like Sunday, this whole thing will get big, you can be able to like write songs about my life.
You'll have to sing me a song one day so I can hear.
Yeah, I might.
So you're not like shy or anything. You'll perform if you ever get a chance.
I sing for Miss Johnson, so.
You sung in the room or for her?
For her.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Like, I'm like shy to sing with like a bunch of people, but when like I moved with Sarah, her husband, he's in a Christian band, and they needed an extra lead singer, and he asked me because I like it was a girl too, and I couldn't find any other girl that could. So he like asked me, I'm like, how many people are gonna be there? He's like 100, maybe 1,000. And I was like, oh, yeah. And he's like, so you wanna do it? And I was like, ask mom.
Yeah.
He's like, well, we need a soprano. And I was like, mom's an alto. And he's like, yeah, a soprano. And I was like, I'm not the right soprano. And then I ended up doing that, and I was like, really nervous when I got there. Like, I felt sick. I was gonna throw up. Like, my stomach was in a row. I was like shaking, you know, I was getting hot.
Yeah.
But then, like, when I went out there, it was like cheering for me and stuff like that. And, like, the more I sing, like, to deep breaths, I felt more comfortable.
That's good. So, emotionally, when you sing, how do you feel? What's going through your body? Or when you write, when you draw, whatever it is you like to do the most, how do you feel?
When I sing, I feel more like calm.
Okay.
And I feel like I'm talking to somebody. But usually when I sing, it's about like deep stuff.
Deep about what?
Like stuff that I guess I would never tell anybody. And you know, like stuff that's like, stuff that kind of just like, you know how like if you were to write, that's just like you only like know, kind of like that stuff.
I want you to go into detail a little bit more.
Yeah.
Just help me understand a little bit more.
for the rumors. So like, by when I say like stuff, like, I don't know.
Give me an example. It can be hypothetical, just to help me understand. So if you were writing right now, or something you've already written, what's a lyric or a line in a poem that you?
Oh, I have in a song I wrote. It's called "Stupid TV Girl."
Okay.
And there's a, I think it's a chorus, or no, this would be the end. So it goes, she knows. I sing that four times. No, I sing it two times, and then you are sick twice, and then please clear four times.
Say she's sick or you're sick or you're sent.
No, it says she knows, mm-hmm. She knows you're sick.
You're sick.
Please clear it before it happens.
So what does that mean?
My mom, she has a really bad drinking problem.
Okay.
And she's like,
this is your biological mother,
yeah,
right?
Okay. She has a really bad drinking problem. And she's like trying to be young and cool. But she's not. And like, she drinks her problems away instead of like getting help. And like, that's why I'm like, on the church, because I feel like she really needs to go. But I invited her to church and stuff like that because like, she drinks a lot.
That's good that you invited her. So you're trying to still have that relationship with her despite, you know, the drinking and everything like that. That's good.
And she's like, see, not helping my sister close folks me, like medical though.
Oh, okay.
But because of my mom getting drunk, she gets stupid and tries to smoke weed.
Your mom?
Yeah.
Oh.
So, like, it's not bad. Like, I've done it before. It's just like, it's not good. Like,
right.
It's not bad for you if they're making it medical. But it's also like, not helping my mom's situation.
It's an addition to her problems that she's already having, so
and
adding
like,
more onto the drinking.
She's so bad. And she's like a really big hoe.
Oh my gosh.
She like, it sounds so bad. Like, I don't know, it just like, I don't like this. Like, it just makes me really mad. Like,
right.
Like,
that's
I just
true.
Get angry at her, so like,
how do you process the anger? Like, what do you do?
I don't know, I tell her straight up sometimes, how I feel.
You tell her straight up, meaning?
I'll tell her if I think she's a hoe.
Oh my gosh, to your mom?
Because I feel like that's something she needs to hear in order to actually get it through her head.
Okay, so what if we, because I don't know what my post-its are. What if we talk about, like, other ways? Because, I mean, I don't want you to think, and I don't know your mom, but I don't want you to think that she's just, you know, drinking or doing all this stuff just because she feels like she has nothing.
I can tell you why she felt because for one, she dated a homeless guy who only used her for food and money and transportation. For one, she didn't even know him. She saw him walking down the street out back.
Well, I mean, maybe there are some things going on mentally with your mom that makes her act.
That's what we're trying to get at right now. Like, everybody's trying to work together to figure out why she's drinking. Like, what's the reason? Why can't she stop? We had a team meeting before with, like, the caseworker, my foster mom, and my family and stuff. Mm-hmm. And we were getting somewhere with it. Like, we asked her, like, what is her purpose of drinking? Like, why does she, something happen to her? Mm-hmm. And then she started opening up, and then she kind of shut down. Because she was scared.
Yeah, that's possible. She was scared.
And I think she's scared because she doesn't want help, but she needs help.
So the only sad part about that is if someone doesn't want help, you can't force them to get it yet. So, I mean, unfortunately, you want your mom to be better, and you want her to get there and get to a point where she's better.
But she's been sober for a while.
Oh, that's good.
But my dad said it's kind of like off.
She's getting somewhere, but you know what I mean? If she's making that progress,
she said she'll go like 2 weeks without drinking, and then like she'll drink like a few nights.
So, what do you do? How do you process that? What do you do when you see your mom, or how often do you see your mom? What is
every Wednesday?
Okay. Has she ever missed a Wednesday because she was too?
No.
Okay,
but
so
she's missed a Wednesday for like during our call classes and stuff.
Right, but not because she was too like messed up to meet with you, or because she didn't want to. So that's good. Your mom is, she's trying, and she hasn't put that like before you or seeing you. So that's good. How do you process? So back to the question, when she is like that, or when that is happening to her, how do you process it? What do you make of that?
I'm kind of like used to it, so I could always like babysat her. That's why I'm like so mature out of everybody here, and like it's kind of why I get along with older people, you know?
Because you had to grow up fast.
Yeah, and I feel like she was my child.
Oh,
and
I'm sorry.
It's I feel like she's my teenager, and that I just never meant to have.
Oh.
But my mom, when I talked to myself, she's like, "But I shouldn't have felt like that. I should have been taking care of her. She should have been responsible for that." And then I just myself alcohol. Like my class mom drank somebody like, she's not very light. Like she knows, like she doesn't drink like a lot of, but she'll drink like 2 cups of wine.
Right.
Like go here and there, but she's not like every night. My mom will drink all the way until like 10 in the morning. It's so bad. And like now, like she's sober somewhat, and I feel like that's kind of good because she's gonna start like her body's because like it's not good for her liver for one.
Right.
And like I think like her body's gonna regulate to being sober and like start getting used to it. Like she doesn't like chocolate or anything like that, but like my dad's trying to get it like one of those patches,
yeah,
like smoking and stuff like that. But she's also not too.
So, I mean, at least you're no longer in the house, right?
No.
So you don't have to see that every day or anything like that, and you still get your supervised visits, so you get to see her, and that's good. So how are you dealing with, what's the boy name? Is that his name?
Yeah.
I don't think I ever asked his name, but just, yeah. Okay, so Manny, how are you with that? Where's your head with that? Because I know when I pulled you, we talked, and then the day after, I know that I told you were pretty kind of sad or whatever because you haven't been thinking about it.
I've thought about it a lot lately. I don't know why. Like, I'll just wake up in the morning and I look at something that's like, oh, that reminds me of it. And not helping the other day, I opened my lunchbox. So I was looking for, like, I don't remember. I was looking for my let, and I usually put it in the front of like my lunchbox zipper.
Mm-hmm.
And I opened it. There's pictures of him in there and me.
Do you still have pictures?
Yeah.
Why haven't you gotten rid of them?
Because I can't find half of them.
Oh, okay. So what did you do when you see that there are pictures of you and him?
I almost cried.
But what did you do?
I just left them in there, and when I got home, I kept them with sisters and threw them in the garbage. So
how did it make you feel?
I don't know. I kind of wish I would see them.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know, because I just really love them. I just really liked him. And I remember like my sister's like, that was first love.
Yeah.
She's like, you don't really can't really get rid of them. Especially his first time too. And it's like I wish I would have seen more of him though.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Just, but you don't think that would have hindered your progress in moving on and
it would have.
So it's probably good that she didn't save it.
Now, not helping, I have a lot of jewelry he bought me.
Yeah, a lot of jewelry, sure. No. Do you wear it? A lot?
Yeah.
So when you look down or when you see it, you just automatically think of him?
Not always. Okay. I think in my future.
Okay.
I try to.
With somebody else.
Yeah. But sometimes, like, honestly, like, usually when I'm alone, like, left alone, my head gets loud, and I just start thinking. Anyway, I don't usually cry when I'm sad. I just start questioning things.
So I like the way you stated that. My head gets loud because when you're quiet, it's like your quiet time is the loudest time. So I like the way you put that. What do you, when your head gets loud, what do you do?
I listen to music, or I just lay down and like close my eyes and like play like a movie. I don't know if anyone, I don't know if you've done that, like you just like make your own movie in your head.
That sounds fun though. I watch a lot of movies.
I did too. I recently just watched It on my
I haven't
It
watched
chapter
it.
2 on my TV last night.
Okay, so let's think of some, let's do strategies here or activities, whatever you want to call them. What can you do when your pain gets loud to help put you in a better place? What's some other activities, things you'd like to do, things you'd love to do?
My friends.
Okay.
Where I can like go in the living room with my foster dad, just hang out with him and watch TV with him. There's anything that's gonna distract you from that.
So it sounds like being around people. It's like you said, it's only when you're alone. So what about the whole writing and singing situation? Do you think that will put you in a better...
Usually when my mic is loud, I do end up singing.
Okay. So you can sing.
Yeah.
You sing like happy, like upbeat songs, not depressing songs that'll keep you in that mood, right? What kind of music?
Sometimes.
So what if we try listening to upbeat and more like dance around, jump
like,
around songs?
Recently, I've been listening to like...
She's, yeah, I have my own opinions about her, but I love Lizzo.
She gives me a lot of confidence.
That's great. So yeah, find those artists that, like you said, give you that confidence, and that their music, if it puts you in a better place, because you don't want to, when you get like that, when your head is loud, you don't remain in that place. That's just not, that puts you nowhere. So
was
you want
to
find an artist.
To my foster mom.
Yeah.
Bit.
I like
something that I can't talk to her about.
Why do you feel like you can't talk to her?
Because she can't stay serious. Like, I know that's like the kind of person she is. Like, she could be serious about certain things, but when it comes to like something, she's not a person that like stays serious.
Oh.
She's like a person who just sits there and starts laughing out of nowhere.
Really? Have you expressed to her like, this is a serious time, a serious moment,
yeah.
So before I start,
she knows what
stay
I tell
serious.
Her. She doesn't mind telling me I have to talk, she knows it's about something serious. It's just like me sitting like serious at first, and like I'll say something like that doesn't even like it's not even funny or make sense.
Yeah.
And she'll just be like, that's funny, and just start laughing. And I'll be like, oh.
Until you tell her no, it's not.
Yeah. She's just like a silly person though. She's just like, I think she does try to make me feel better.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it works though.
That's good.
Because she's like really outgoing. And ever since I met her, I've gotten like out of my comfort zone a little way too much.
How so?
She like taught me how to just be myself.
Your mom's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. She just taught me how to like love myself for who I am. Still working on that though.
Yeah.
Like she's like my foster. You know what I'm talking about, my foster mom.
Yeah.
So like my foster mom. And she's like somewhat. She's a really big butt. So she's really self-conscious about like her thighs. Like I'm not calling her fat. She's not fat. She has a really nice body.
Right.
She's like thicker.
Mm-hmm.
So like yeah. And like she said how like she really got self-conscious about she had kids and stuff like that. And like I always tell her too, like she gets stressed in the morning, but like she can do it.
Mm-hmm.
And like she's strong.
So it sounds like you guys work together to build each other's confidence. That's great. That is great.
What if my mom's not wearing makeup? She always wears makeup. I was like, you look pretty today. And she's like, thanks, I don't need makeup on. I was like, no, you do. And she's like, uh-huh. And I was like, you really do? And he's like, mm-hmm. And she doesn't like to agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
Usually, I tell her to, like, makeup is like, what's going to bring you confidence. It's like, going to bring you confidence when you wear it.
Yep. So you guys are working together. I like that. That's amazing. So it sounds like home is where your head is like busy the most. How are you at school?
I get sidetracked a lot.
How so? Like,
I don't know, it's kind of hard to focus. Like, I'll just like be listening first. I feel like I have ADHD. I do. Because like, I'll be focusing on one thing and then I'll go into the next thing and I'll be like, wait, what?
It's like squirrel.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't necessarily say ADHD. There's a couple other factors that go into that. I was just in looked down for like 2 seconds, and I'm like, wait a minute, what did I miss? Like, I don't know what I was doing. I looked down at my nails, and then I looked back up, and they were flipping the page, and I'm like, wait, I looked down for 2 seconds.
It's
what is happening?
Weird because like you are listening, but if you like focus, everything just looks quiet.
Right.
In your head. And you're just like, what? No one covered my ears.
Right.
What is
happening? I know that you all are talking.
It's
but,
just weird that our brain does that. Just like close and that.
Yes, it does.
Because like I'll be like so into a book or something, mm-hmm. and like it's done. But okay, so everybody gets your Chromebooks. Okay.
Right. Because
I see everyone. Like,
it's like you just drift off, but you're not the only one who does that. So good. I mean, as long as you're paying attention, and I think you're doing pretty good. You were just in an honor roll for breakfast. So again, congrats on that. So, you gotta get back to class, or is it lunchtime for you? It's lunch. Okay, I'll get you to lunch. Thank you. I just wanted to check in and then give you those like strategies to kind of help you reel your mind in and just keep working on being a better you. Because I know. Down in there, and you're going to be that role model that everyone says you have to be to these younger kiddos down on this side of the hallway. So we're going to keep working on it.